Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. I hope everything is well on your side. Before moving ahead in this video, please pause this video and comment below that your app is working so far. In this video, we will do some changes in our API call code. It is working well, but I just want to make the calls a bit more abstract. And I also want to handle the errors at a single place. As you can see, we have the user login inside our user repository and it is giving us a response of type auth response. But I don't want my view model to worry about the response, as if we get the response in our view model every time we need to check response is successful. So I want to do this thing at a single place. And to do this, we need to create a generic function that will perform the API request and return the response. So from that generic function, we will get the response directly of our response type. In this case, we have auth response. So inside your network package, create one more class and name this class Safe API Request, because we will handle the errors here. So we have the file Safe API Request. Inside this file, I will create an abstract class Safe API Request. And inside this class, I will create another suspend function because we want to perform a network operation and it is an asynchronous operation. And for async task, we use suspend. So we have suspend fun and this function is a generic function. So we will define here T of type any. And we will name this function as API request because this function will perform an API request. And this function will return us T. Now to this function, we will pass our API call. And this call is another suspend function. So we have suspend function with no parameter. And this function will return us a response of type T. That's it. Now inside this function API request, we will invoke the call and we will get the response. So we have val response equals to call dot invoke. Now we have the response from the API call and we can check if the response is successful, return response dot body and make sure it is not null. Because if the response is successful, we have the response body. In case response is not successful, we will handle the error. So first, we will get the error from the response error body. So we have val error equals to response dot error body. So if the response is not successful, we cannot get the body, but we can get the error body and we will get the string from the error body. So whatever the response is in our error, we will get the string format of that. So first, let me show you the API. So we have Postman. So when we have an invalid login attempt, we have the status code 401. And when we have the response code as 401, that means it is an error and we will come inside the else block. So inside the else block, we are getting this string that is the JSON object. So in case we are getting the error response that we defined in our API code, then it is okay. We can parse the JSON response, but sometimes we can get some errors like 404 that the API not found or your host is not working. So in that case, you will not get the JSON response body. But before validating the JSON, first we need to check if this error is not null. So we will check error, then question mark dot let. And inside this let block, we will convert this error string, which is it, to a JSON object. But it can only be converted to a JSON object when we have a JSON object in our error response. So if we coded this error in our API, we have the JSON response, JSON error response. But in case the error is something else, we will not get a JSON response. For example, API not found or host not working error. So we need to do a try and catch to convert the JSON response to check the string is convertible to a JSON object or not. So inside try, we will convert the string to a JSON object and we will get the error message. As I designed my API that in case of error response, I always have this message key that contains the error message. So you are also using my API, so no problem in this case. But when you are working in your application, you need to design your APIs accordingly. So here I will get the error message from the JSON object that we have in this string or that we may have in this string. So I will write JSON object, I will pass it, and then from this JSON object I will get the string and it is message. So if we have a JSON response in our error response, we will get the message. But when we don't have the JSON response in our error response, we will come inside this catch block. But we are not doing anything inside this catch block, because when we come inside the catch block, we will only display the response code, that is our error code. But when we have some message to display when there is an error, we will display the message. So what I will do here is I will create a string builder. So I will create message with this string builder. Now instead of creating this message, I can write here message.append and I will append the error message that we have. So I will cut it and I will paste it inside. So we have the error message inside this string builder. Then after this try and catch, I will append a new line to my message. So let's append a new line. And then after this let block, I will append the error code in our message string builder. So here I will write message.append and I will append error code and I will get the error code from this response object. So here we will write response dollar curly braces response.code. That's it. So we have the message. On the first line we have the error message, if any, and on the second line we have the error code. Then we will throw exception, and to handle our API exception, I will create a custom class API exception, and all the custom exceptions that we want in this project I will store it inside my util package. So let's create a new Kotlin file here and I will name it exceptions. And inside this file, I will create all the classes. So first class that we want is API exception. And this class will take message of type string as a constructor parameter and it will inherit the IO exception. And we will pass the message to the IO exception. That's it. Now come back to save API request. And here we will throw the API exception. So we will write throw API exception. And we will pass the message to string. This message, and we will convert this message to string. So we are throwing an API exception in case of any error. So we have the generic function ready and we will use this function to perform the API request. So come inside your user repository class and this class will extend safe API request. Now we can use this function that we created here, which is API request, to perform our API request inside the user repository class. So what I will do is I will write here return API request, and inside this API request I will call my API, then user login and email password. That's it. Now we can change the return type to auth response. Now our function is returning the auth response directly. So come back to auth view model, and here we will get the auth response directly. So let's do it like this: val auth response equals to user repository dot user login, and we will pass email and password, the same thing. Actually, I just written the same line with the auth response, but here we do not need to check if the response is successful, but we need to put this auth response inside try and catch, and we need to catch the API exception. So we have E of type API exception. Now when we have an error, we will call the auth listener dot on failure, and we will pass the message that we will get from this exception instance. So we can pass E dot message, and we can make sure it is not null. In case we have an auth response, we will call auth listener dot on success, and we will get the user from the auth response. So we will write auth response dot user, and it can be null. So we need to write here auth response dot user, and then we need to make sure that user is not null. If the user is not null, we will call on success and we will pass it. That is the user that is not null. In case the user is null, we can again call this on failure and we can get the message from the auth response. So we will write auth response dot message, and we will make sure it is not null. Now after this success, we will call return so that it will not execute this line even when there is a success, and that's it. I think it should work. So let's try running our application. So let's try login in. If we put empty values, we are getting invalid email or password. Let's put correct values. And we are getting Bilal Khan is logged in. So it is working absolutely fine. In case of any error, let's try this as well. So we are getting invalid email or password. Error code 401. So it is working absolutely fine. But I want to display a snack bar instead of this toast. As you can see in our layout file, we used a coordinator layout. You see, it is a coordinator layout. And I use this layout because I want to use snack bar instead of toast. And again, for snack bar, I will create one more extension function. So come inside view utils, and here I will create an extension function of view. So I will write fun view dot snack bar, and this function will take the message that we want to display inside the snack bar. And here I can write snack bar dot make, and the first parameter it takes is the view, and we have the view here because this function is the extension of view, so we can simply pass this here. Then for the second parameter, we have the message that we want to display, and for the third parameter, we have the length of the snack bar. So we have snack bar dot length long, and then I will write also, and this also will give us the snack bar. Now to the snack bar, I will set an action like this. So we have snack bar dot set action, and I will name the button name as OK, and inside the click function, which is this, this is actually a lambda. Inside this function or lambda, I will dismiss the snack bar. So I will write snack bar dot dismiss. And then finally, after this curly bracket, we can call show to show the snack bar. So it is very easy. Now instead of toast, we can use the snack bar. But to use the snack bar, we need the coordinator layout. And you can see I have given this coordinator layout an ID, which is root layout. So I can use this. So come back to login activity, and here instead of toast, I will write root layout dot snack bar, and then I will pass the same string that I want to display. That's it. Now delete the toast, and we can use the same thing everywhere. So in case of failure, we will display the failure message, and we are good. So try running the application again, and this time you will see a snack bar. You can see it is working. We have the snack bar. Now put some wrong password, and it is working fine. So I think it is better than toast. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you enjoyed this lesson and you made it working on your site. In case you have any problem, let me know in the comments below. And please guys, like this video and share to your friends. Thanks for watching. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.